Next, the ladies take the ice when we come back.
You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Too much love drives a man insane. You broke my will, but what a thrill. Mr. Ray, this is great, balls of fire.
Michelle Kwan certainly is on fire, undefeated this year in competition, which leads us now to the Aflac trivia question. Trivia question for today, which U.S. woman has won the most world championships? We'll have an answer for you coming up shortly. Once again, I'm Tracy Wilson along with Peter Carruthers. And Peter, whenever Michelle Kwan goes into a competition, she takes with her the title of overwhelming favorite. And I guess it's true that she has to make a mistake to lose.
Well, she is such a strong skater and really tough to beat. But there is some consensus in the Russian camp that Maria Butyrskaya can be very competitive. Remember, at the Russian Nationals, she landed 7 triples. That was just last month. So we'll see how that plays out here. And we must mention the world champion from 1994, Yuka Sato. She won that world championship just down the street in Chiba, Japan. And now she's in front of her countrymen, so that could be a real boost for her here.
Michelle Kwan has competed 3 times in Japan. Since winning an Olympic silver medal last year in Nagano, Michelle's popularity has grown considerably in this country. Before competition are always busy ones for Michelle, not only with the demands from her skating, but with the media frenzy that surrounds her at every competition. Especially here in Tokyo, where Michelle is truly respected and loved by her Japanese fans. We had the opportunity to spend a day with Michelle to see how demanding her schedule can really get.
It's a big day, Tokyo. TV
appearances. Michelle begins her day with her competition sponsors.
We usually sit down before the season and talk about what I'd like out of my skating.
While the sponsors and the media have their eyes on Michelle, she has her eyes on the merchandise.
Yeah, I could imagine driving this one. Looks like me, huh? I
can
touch the grass.
Michelle is on to her next stop with Fuji Television. She's appearing on Super News, talking to Yuka Sato via satellite. She's ready for her last appearance.
I'm ready.
The show is professional news. The host of the show, Dabu Okubo, was the catcher of the Yomiuri Giants from 1990 to 1994.
So when I go out there, I just think about what I have to do when I'm on the ice. Like you do in baseball, you know? You concentrate on the ball,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
So when I go out there, I just concentrate.
Yeah. 18歳に教わってしまいました、私は。やっぱしっかりしてますね。It's a joke. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
ありがとうございました。
Enough work for the day. Now it's time to play.
Funky shoes, man. Do you like? Let's go try on hats. No.
No, because of fun.
That's a little pink. Let's go clothing. It's too complicated. Too complicated.
Great.
That's my next costume, Mom.
Oh, yeah.
Great idea.
The day is done, but not for the press. They are now busy working on featuring Michelle Kwan in every Tokyo newspaper for the following morning.
I get overwhelmed because they watch and they pretty much know who I am and what I do. And I think it's a great feeling. It's like an honor to be known and for someone to come up to me and want my autograph because, you know, to them, they'll cherish that piece of paper. And you just... It took you 2 seconds to write your name, you know, and it feels great to be recognized and someone coming up to you and knowing who you are and what you do. and pretty much knowing everything that you do.
Well, it was a busy day for Michelle Kwan, but if you're a world champion, that is what is expected of you. Now taking a look at the ladies' short program, here is the order of skate. Michelle Kwan will be first on the ice, followed by Karen Kadavy, Fumiya Sugure of Japan, Yuka Sato of Japan, and then the two Russian skaters, Irina Slutskaya and Maria Butraskaya, will round things out. The last time Michelle Kwan was in Japan, she finished second at the Olympic Games. A month later, she went on to win the World Championship. This year, she has entered six events. She has won them all, plus 20 perfect scores. Michelle is skating to the fate of Carmen.
Again, required elements within this short program. She opens with a difficult one, the triple lutz, double tolu. Only perfect. Slightly, Peter. Yes, going back to that jump that she doubled, the rules say you can do a double or a triple jump, so she won't take a deduction for that.
Well, we'll see what the judges thought of Michelle Kwan. The answer to our Aflac trivia question, the American woman that has won the most world championships, Carol Heiss, 5 years in a row, starting in 1956.
The triple lutz, right up high, beautifully done. And then the double axel, she gets into the air, nice tight rotation with the arms in close. And look at the way she finishes this jump. This was only a double. Two rotations, she would have liked a triple, but again, I have to emphasize that she won't take a deduction for that. It's not as difficult, but we're in the short program for required elements.
And now the scores. These are required elements for Michelle Kwan, and they range from 5.4 to 5.7.
And she would have liked to have seen a higher 5-7 from the Korean judge had she done that triple, but no deduction. Look at this.
5-8 across the board for Michelle Kwan for presentation.
Hold on, back.
Yeah, well.
Can't believe that.
On the ice now, second American skater in this competition. One of the veterans, she won her world medal back in 1986. Here is Karen Kadavy, skating to Santana. What's interesting to note with this program is it has vocals. So right off the top, it's a 0.1 deduction.
This jet lag, not easy to do. This was good, the triple toe loop, good rotation, and then she steps right up to the double toe loop. Strong for her to get past that, and then she wanted a triple here, however, only a double. But no deduction.
We're ready now. With the marks for acquired elements for 31-year-old Karen Kadavy. And what a range, Peter. 4.4 up to 5.0.
Yes, also a hand touching down on one of the jumps.
Presentation marks. These come up nicely. They range from 5.1 to 5.5. On the ice, from Japan, Fumiya Suguri. She has always dreamed of skating with Michelle Kwan. She expected her first time to be at the World Championship. She got an early chance to skate with Michelle here. 17 years of age, hoping to win the national championship and earn a spot at the world team. Program. She went to Canada to have the program choreographed by Michelle Kwan's choreographer, Lori Nichol.
coming out of it not her best. It's the Gary's Mark after this. And now the marks for Fumiya Suguri for required elements. These range from 5.0 to 5.4.
5.0, 5.1, 5.0, 5.2.
Let's see what happens here. These are much better. That's right, Tracy. Potential.
On the ice now, also from Japan, here is 25-year-old Yuka Sato. Her music is Roundabout.
Very good. great program.
And the first clean one we've seen in this event.
Clean with no mistakes. And what I really liked about it was the tempo change. Not only did she perform all the difficult elements, but at the end of the program, she changed the pace to a nice, soothing, relaxed look. She performed everything very well. Great job, Yuka Sato.
Two-time national champion. She won her world title back in 1994 here in Japan. Brought out the best in her there.
And started the ball off rolling in the right direction with that great triple loop, double toe loop. The air position is superb, and the carriage she has across the ice with her upper body is excellent. Again, another nice triple, just following through. She's got great experience, and where she shines, actually like Kurt Browning, is in the footwork. Her feet are so excellent.
And now the first set of marks for Yuka Sato. These were required elements. 5-3, 5-5, Peter.
Somewhat low from the Russian judge. I would like to have seen those higher. Certainly more up in this area for the presentation.
5-5 to 5-7 for Yuka Sato for presentation. Job well done. Second in the world last year, the first Russian lady ever to win the European title. Here is 19-year-old Irina Lutskaya.
Getting started with the first jump, but then she followed through with a really nice second triple jump.
I think she's worked quite a bit on her artistry this year also, Peter, and I'm not sure it's in everybody's taste, but you can really see how her arms have softened.
She's maturing. She's becoming a young lady. And that is challenging to manage all the jumps along with that. And this is where she got into trouble. She gets up into the air. The rotation's good, but watch how she almost comes to a stop before the second jump and then does pull off the second jump, but it didn't have good flow and speed. This was really good. She carried through, and look at the landing. Very sure on that. And as you mentioned, Tracy, what makes this spin so unique and different is the Bielman position. Of course, Denise Bielman, the 1981 world champion, invented that move and done on both feet.
And now the first set of marks for required elements for Irina Slutskaya. Wow, lead range 5.5-5.7. Good mark, Peter.
Very solid mark for Irina Slutskaya, for sure. The presentation could come in some cases higher. That's going to put her in a good position.
Well, this indeed has put pressure on Michelle Kwan. Irina Slutskaya up next. Her teammate, Maria Butryskaya, will be back in a minute.
Backstage now with Karen Kadavy. You just got off a plane less than 24 hours ago. That was not bad, considering.
Thank you. I was pleased with it. I mean, I was pleased with my combination. I just felt a little sluggish out there, just maybe because of the travel and the time zones and stuff. But otherwise, it was fun. The audience was great, and I tried to have a lot of fun out there while I was at it.
You still enjoy competing in these?
I do. I enjoy competing, but some of the pro-ams with the, you know, IC rules, it's a little nerve-wracking a little bit, just seeing those points afterwards and like deduction, you're like, oh, a little bit, feels a little bit bad, but I try to see beyond it and be happy with what I did, so.
Well, all things considered, you skated great tonight.
Thank you so much, appreciate it.
On the ice now, she won the bronze medal at the World Championships in 1998. Completed 7 triple jumps at the Russian Championships in early January. Champion of Russia, Maria Butryskaya. The music, Once Upon a Time in America. Putintskaya.
Now the question remains, Tracy, will she beat Michelle Kwan in this short program? Because she landed a triple loop for her triple jump, and Michelle only did a double. So it will be interesting to see what happens.
This, again, the short program, emphasis on the required elements. It is only worth, though, a third of the total mark.
This was a very high triple Lutz jump, and she really stays perpendicular to the ice, allowing her good rotation on the second jump. Look at the nice, solid position as she takes off into the air, and good elbows, arms in tight, and landing with authority. She has a lot more confidence in her skating.
Keep an eye on the marks for Maria Butyrskaya, and remember, Michelle Kwan had 5-4 spot to 5-7. Here's a look at Maria's required elements, and Peter, these range from 5-3 to 5-8.
An interesting set of marks, but the presentation scores will tell the story.
Lower than Michelle Kwan, these were 5-8, 5-6 to 5-8 for Maria Butyrskaya. Maria Butyrskaya will have to settle for second after the ladies' short program. Despite an uncharacteristic mistake by Michelle Kwan, she is the leader.
Has been brought to you by Carlson Vaughan Lee Travel. Are you ready? Ready for some fun? All of our sunny destinations are on sale now. Call your Carlson Vaughan Lee Travel agent today. And by Sitco. You know a neighbor when you see one.
Maya Usova and Yevgeny Platov continue to dazzle in ice dance. They are clearly the leaders after the original dance. In the pairs event, it's Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Tsikhirlidze. They're in first after the short program, but in a tight race with Witzel and Steuer from Germany. Yevgeny Plushenko was the star of the men's short program. But he's keeping an eye on Todd Eldridge of the United States and Russian teammate Alexei Yagudin. Michelle Kwan, on top in the ladies' short program. Sitting just ahead of two Russian skaters, Maria Butyrskaya and Irina Slutskaya. Now let's rejoin Alice Cook.
Well, I'm backstage with Michelle Kwan, the leader after the technical program. You can't be perfect every night, I guess, right?
No, I guess not. And you saw that, but I don't know what happened. I just walked into the triple tell like usual, and I came out and I did a double, and I went, wait a minute. I'm missing a rotation there. I don't know. I just have to learn from this mistake and hopefully do better at nationals.
I heard you had a whirlwind tour of Tokyo the other day. What was that like?
It was fun. I got to see a lot of Tokyo. There was a lot of people there, but it was fun.
And your approach for the long program?
Just have fun.
East of Eden again.
East of Eden. It's a fun program. And just listen to the music. And I think if I listen to the music, I'll just automatically go.
Michelle Kwan turning her focus to tomorrow in the Interpretive Free program, where she will try to hold off Maria Butyrskaya. For Alice Cook and Peter Carruthers, I'm Tracy Wilson, reminding you to watch the interpretive programs tomorrow right here on TNT at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Goodbye from Japan.